Greetings, Eric Back, a naturopath from New Zealand. I've got another question here from a subscriber. Is chronic and progressive arthritis linked to candida? Well, it depends what type of arthritis we're dealing with. There's different forms of arthritis. There's osteoarthritis, or the wear and tear one. There's rheumatoid arthritis, which is autoimmune arthritis. And there's gouty arthritis, which is built up of uric acid in the body. So I'm assuming that you talking about osteoarthritis here. That's generally not linked to candida at all. That's more of a genetic component, and also wear and tear on the body can involve different types of joints, like the back or the hips or the knees, the shoulders. Osteoarthritis tends to be more of inflammatory, and heat and pain by nature often involves the smaller joints like the wrists or the fingers. And it's autoimmune, so that's the immune system attacking different tissues, you know, joint tissues. It is fair to say that if you've got any gut-related issues, and many people with arthritis have got gut-related issues, that they should get on top of those problems. So if you've got arthritis and you're watching this now, my first recommendation is to try and get your digestive system up to a very high level of health. So if there's any bloating or gas, any constipation or diarrhea, if you've got known food allergies, these things all need to be resolved. It's very important to have an excellent digestive system, because that will allow the joints to rebuild. Okay, it's a fair comment to say that every so many years the body renews itself, the tissues get replaced, and it's based on the kind of quality food that you're eating. So by eating really good food all the time and improving digestive health, you're going to allow the joints to rebuild. You also maybe need to be assessed for toxins in the body, so there's different ways that can be assessed by your clinician as well. So detoxification may also be necessary, particularly in the early stages of treatment of arthritis. It might be good. And of course, there are certain supplements that you might want to take for arthritis as well. But these things should all be discussed with your physician. So I can't see a direct link with candida, and different forms of arthritis like osteo. Many rheumatoid patients do have candida of some degree. It needs to be fixed up. They often have a kind of a focal infection. So rheumatoid arthritis has been linked to things like diseased teeth or small infections in the tonsils or small infections really around the valve, the ileocecal valve or the appendix. These could form little hotspots and really cause inflammatory reactions. So anyone with rheumatoid arthritis should have a stool test done by default, to determine if there's any inflammatory gut condition going on that needs cleaning up as well. And candida could well be a part of that gut condition. So, I hope that answers the question. Thanks for tuning in.